Fairview's coffee has mysteriously gone missing. Mayhem ensues when strange, coffee-craving zombies plague the city. Detective Mickey Potatoes, an overworked public servant, uncovers why ordinary citizens are losing their minds and how to stop the coffee apocalypse. But it involves the mafia. And when you're dealing with mafia crime families, nothing is ever easy. The mafia controls everything in the city, including the police, including him. If he breaks the mafia, they will break him. So, the city is without coffee. The city is burning before his very eyes, but he's powerless. Detective Potatoes has the power to stop the coffee apocalypse, but if he does, he could lose everything.
It's me, Pops Van Marmalade, and you're watching the Comics Related Madness Network. Huh? So come get some.
The Madness Comic Network and Comic Related Madness proudly presents Madness Open Drawstring, featuring the richness and a variety of special guests. Tune in to our content on Comic Talk with Pops Van Zandt on YouTube.
I'm a strange guy.
Really?
Yeah, I worry. I mean, little things bother me.
And I see your Schwartz is as big as mine.
We're all alone, no chaperone can get our number. The world's in slumber, let's misbehave.
Do me a favor, please. Get out of here. Get out of here, man. Shit, I'm saying.
Good morning.
Hi.
How are you, cats? It should be 1 o'clock in the PM over there. And hey, old Billy Power Max. Yeah, man. Well, I sent the code out to a bunch of you scrubs. Hopefully you're there. Would be cool if you were. I don't know if Pop wants to come out. If Pop wants to come out, come on out.
Won't you get in trouble if the boss shows up?
Oh, no, it's the boss here? Hey, wait, I'm the boss.
There he is.
Get in trouble if the boss shows up? Seven where he is, but not where I'm at. No. It's 1 o'clock in the afternoon on the East Coast in the United States of America. Welcome to the Madness Open Draw Stream.
Yeah.
There's links. You're allowed to come out here and hang out with Rich. It doesn't matter what your name is. Can you draw?
It doesn't matter what your name is.
Hello, Frank.
My name is Frank. Frank Max Power.
Billy, what's up, everybody? I see we got lurkers as well. Welcome to the show. You're here to see him draw. You're not here to listen to me talk. So, to make sure everybody understands that, this is an open draw stream, and if you draw, you're welcome to come out and hang out with Rich and draw. This is episode 69.
Sure as fuck is. How about that?
It's hard to believe you made it that far, isn't it, Rich?
69 is a very familiar number to me, so, man, I don't know.
No, that's not what I mean. You made it to 69 episodes, dude.
Yeah, I didn't think, you thought we wouldn't?
No, because there was times when I was like, dude, you're just going to have to take the show. And you're like, I'm not doing it by myself.
I haven't done it by myself.
I know. You make me be out here, too. That's the only way you
made
it.
Oh, baby. Oh, my God. I'd be crying. Jesus, man.
You heard we're called what?
What happened?
No. We have a network that has all kinds of different shows. Comic shows, gaming shows, talk shows. The network has, all different kinds of stuff. If draw streams aren't your thing and gaming is, you tune in on Friday. Pretty much all day is Madness Gaming, different kinds of stuff. D&D, we got Manicore that does live video gaming. We got all kinds of stuff going on the network. So I don't know why we're called Comics Game. We are the Madness is what we are. The Madness Comic.
The Madness. We are the Madness Comic.
And Frank, what do you do? Are you are you an artist, a writer? Are you just a comic fan? What are you up to? What do you do?
Hey, man, what do you do, Frank? Got five people here.
And I don't know where our people are at, but it's time.
They'll be here.
Yeah. Let me just drop this link in a few places just because.
Yeah, here we are.
Did you send it to Brianna?
Brianna, I don't have Twitter, man.
Oh, okay. Well,
Brianna's not on Facebook at all. That's my knowledge.
So what are you drawing, huh?
I'm still drawing that thing I did yesterday.
Dungeons and Dragons.
Dunkin' Donuts? Wow. Yeah, man. Drawing Dunkin' Donuts. I love that. I love that stuff.
He's into mergers and
acquisitions. You got someone. We got someone. Yeah. Perhaps we can play his music.
That's it. Relax.
All right.
Thank you.
Everybody, welcome the host of our game stream on Friday morning, Mr. Max DeVille. He's also manager and founder of Atrocity Press.
That's right.
What's up, man?
Yes.
What's going on?
It's Friday. We're doing what we do. if you're into mergers and acquisitions there, Frank, I'm always looking for other networks to merge with. We're in the process of building a Roku network for this kind of stuff, for comic-related stuff, pop culture stuff, whatever. So if you're into mergers and acquisitions, you know.
I'm into murders and executions.
There you go. Exactly. That's what Dungeons and Dragons is all about, for sure.
Dungeons and Dragons. That was like that really obscure 80s cartoon from a long time ago.
That's been trying to kill us for 21 weeks. 21. That's right.
I probably would have did it, too, if like you wouldn't left on Friday. Because the Fan of the Night Serpent, that's where it really starts to get difficult. That's where you guys are heading into now.
Right. Yeah, well, you know me. I just kill stuff. That's all I do.
Yep.
I carry. Carrie says, "Hi, Pops, Max, and looks like there's somebody else. It's hard to tell. It's so dark where they are." just say hi to Carrie, Rich. Just say hi to Carrie.
Hi to Carrie, Rich. That's what I said. Hi to Carrie, Rich. I don't care about that. Look at this. No, I'm just thinking a few things. That's all.
So I don't know where our people are. Where's our doc?
Yeah.
I send invites. Send invites to a whole bunch of our people. Q's here.
The Q is here. Next time, let me do the thing, dude. Don't just tell everybody it's here.
Whatever. Do the thing then, man.
Well, everybody knows he's here now, but Rich is talking, so if you ever heard something so stupid, the Q shows up to tell you how pathetic humans are.
That's fucked up.
Well, he's here to tell you exactly.
And this is why aliens won't talk to us.
Oh, thanks. Thanks, Q. Some friend. That's all right. It's all good.
It's all good. Hey, what's up, y'all?
It's all right. Just relaxing, drawing some stuff.
I had a little mishap about an hour ago.
Oh, yeah?
Really? What happened?
Yeah, I went to go up the stairs, and I've had surgery on my right knee twice in my life. And I went to go upstairs earlier, and the right knee said, and totally gave out underneath me after I dropped all my weight on it.
Oh, jeez.
Bounced my head off the fucking arm rail and everything. Yeah, it was fun.
That's kind of smart.
Oh, dude, my knee hurts so bad I can't even stand up right now. I actually have a walking stick next to the fucking chair so that I can use it to get out the chair.
Hmm.
It hasn't felt like it since the last time I had surgery on it.
Damn, dude.
Sorry to hear that, Pop.
After another, I ain't going to get
surgery. Surgery's no joke.
Tell me about it. It lays you up for weeks, months.
Yeah.
I've been there twice. Mm-hmm.
Here's something I'll never say in my entire life. Oh,
you will too.
No, I won't. Never.
As soon as she ain't in the chat, you'll be like, "Where's Carrie?"
I'm not gonna care.
Yeah, you will.
No, I won't.
I bet.
I bet.
You'll lose.
Probably not.
Your narcissistic ass notices when people are not in the chat.
So. I am not that much of a fucking narcissist. I don't want to hear that. Pot me fucking kettle. I don't want to hear your shit.
You'll be watching. You'll be like,
"How come we can't?" No, I won't. Trust me, I won't. narcissist. Eat a dick. Oh, God.
Careful, Rich. Careful.
What? What?
Careful.
Careful how?
Take it easy. So how you doing, Rich?
None of your business. I am being super elusive today.
What today?
I don't know. I'm doing all right, man. How about you?
I'm doing okay. I mean, it's a chill Sunday.
It is a chill Sunday. It is a chill Sunday. Yeah, today's just meh. It's usually muggy around here in the summer. And a lot of times it's like the sun comes in, the sun comes out. It always remains super muggy, and once in a great while it's like, oh, I think I've had enough of all this.
Drawing Deadpool?
I'm finishing up the drawing that I was doing before.
Okay.
And spared the delight of me in chat, but unlucky for you, I'm still alive to steal. Okay. Victim. Right. Okay.
She OD'd on heroin?
I guess. Her OD doesn't concern me. Okay. Hero. Let's see. All right, well, let's see. All right. Let's see. Yeah, I know. Let's see what Q is drawing.
Okay.
Well lit room.
It may look like a,
that's a funny joke.
Well written. It's actually a sun's natural light from the sun.
I know, right?
You can't beat Mother Nature.
So just sit right down, relax, open your ears real wide, and say, "Give it to me straight, Doctor. I can take it."
Wow, the doctor is in, baby. What's going
on?
What's up,
Doc? How you doing, man?
Hey, Rich. What's up, Doc?
Good to see you, gentlemen. Hello, Carrie. Hello, Billy.
Yeah, what's up, Doc?
What's cooking?
What's up, Doc?
What's new, Pussycat? Whoa.
How you doing, Doc?
I'm all right. The air conditioner has gone out in my studio.
Yeah.
It is a temporary.
Oh man, I'm sorry.
Temporary problem. Hopefully, I'm just letting it. The cooling coils frosted.
Doing over. All right? You okay, there, man? I hear it's bad. I hear it's really bad.
The cooling coils frosted over, so. Letting them thaw out, then I can fire it back up. Let me switch this to there. All right. Hello, Amanda.
Amanda! Holy shit.
There we go.
On next week's episode of Will Max Live or Won't He?
We're going to have a guest here in a minute. Her name is Amanda Marriott. She is the person who put together Beachside Comic Con, and this is what this double page, big old nasty ass Wolverine Deadpool drawing is for. She's going to join us in a few minutes.
Right on.
And
right
she's going to talk about her convention. She's going to talk about how we met and how friends we are and blah, 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 and all that stuff. So there you go.
Okay.
How much Rich sucks as a person.
Yeah, how much Rich sucks as a person?
That's right.
Why do I suck as a person?
I don't know. She's got her own reasons, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah. Fuck all of you. Honestly. Fuck every one of you.
That was well played, is what that was.
Yeah, I'm sure it was.
Everybody hates me, so I don't give a fuck.
Nobody hates anybody.
I'm a narcissist, so that breaks my heart when someone doesn't love me.
There's no hate here in this stream. There's nothing but love and kindness.
It'll be quiet.
He says as Pop comes in with, "We didn't know Rich had friends." All right, let me mute. I'm going to get set up here, see if the AC will run and get set up for my drawing.
Take it easy.
So on the script for Lady Blasphemy, Rich, we haven't really changed a whole lot. We just added a whole bunch of stuff. And the very first issue is very Highlander-esque with them having a fight in a parking garage.
Oh, you got to be kidding. Which one?
The Highlander.
Well, no, I'm talking about which parking garage, so I can get a little reference on it. Just like your average one?
Oh, yeah, it's just the general generic parking garage. There'll be a couple car impacts and stuff like that as they get knocked around inside of the building, the parking garage.
I can't wait. I cannot wait.
It'll be good stuff.
Super hyped for that, honestly, because it's gonna push the envelope of whatever storytelling ability I have. That's gonna be some fun stuff.
Yeah, it'll be good shit to do for sure.
Cannot wait. Bold Cat Studio.
And I do give the artist a lot of leeway. I mean, I'm not like one of those. When me and Johnny write a script, we keep it kind of minimal. Because one of the things we hire artists for is their ability to have an imagination.
Well, every page that I do thumbnails for, we're going to review. I'll send you thumbnails for each page.
Yeah.
Give you all the input that's necessary as far as that's concerned. And then when you and Johnny both approve said thumbnails, that's when we go in and I start on the pages. I take care of the pencil pages and I show those to you. And if both of you approve those, I ink those and then I send those. Then send those right to you.
Okay. Cool.
Yep. Well, that's how I always do it. There, Q. That's how I always do it.
That'll work.
This is how you do it.
Yeah, I know. It's all sexiness. Not like you though, Kubi. You're super sexy.
I can't stand how sexy. Basically, we do the same thing. We have it to where, like an artist does their job. If it's pencils or inking or colors or whatever, and then that gets dropped into our WhatsApp group, and it gets approved by me and Johnny and Fernando. And then once it's approved by everybody, you drop your little thing in the payment WhatsApp group, and then that's how we keep track of who's paid.
You get that, Rich? You got to drop your little thing.
I know. I had why I was leaving it alone. I wasn't going to say a word. You know, I wasn't going to say an effing word, and then all of a sudden, you know, I have to drop my little thing. And all right, Doc.
Yo.
I have to drop my little thing.
You know, it's one of those things, Rich, where we just got to do what we got to do.
Yeah, we have to work on what we got, right?
Let's do the best we can with what we got.
Do the best we can with what we got. Yeah.
No, I always like to say, I'm hung like a tuna can. I'm not going to bottom out, but you're going to feel it.
You know,
the
those,
cheese wheel.
Oh, yeah. You know, the Cheerios?
The cheese wheel.
Responsible for the holes in there.
Oh, my God.
That used to be one of my, when I was in the Army, like one of my buddies used to use this pickup line on all these girls, and it worked. He's like, I got a tiny penis. Do you want to see?
God. Jeez.
And let me guess. He was like Dirk Diggler or some shit like that.
I don't know. I never saw that shit. Because every time I was doing UAs, he was the assistant.
What's up, Topple?
So. Happy birthday, Stephen D. I didn't know it was your birthday.
Yeah, I didn't know it was his birthday either.
Happy birthday, Stephen. Know his
birthday at all.
His mom's birthday. Everybody say hi, Stephen's mom. Happy birthday.
Hi, Stephen's mom. Happy birthday.
Hi, Stephen's mom.
Oh. I don't know Stephen's mom.
Not like Stacy's mom.
Don't know your mama jokes today. Got it.
Hey, Tadpole, you feeling any better?
Oh, yeah, I can walk. It's all nice. Right.
Yeah. Oh, Jesus.
It's a miracle.
It's a miracle. It's a miracle.
You're British. You can't sing that.
Yes, no. I can. That's Culture Club, you dolt. Jesus Christ, man.
What?
Stop. Just no, no.
What's adult?
What?
I thought he was going to question Culture Club.
Was questioning Culture Club.
What's adult? Seriously?
Only adult.
Yeah, don't you ever watch, like, didn't you ever watch Bugs Bunny?
You don't know what adult is? Have you ever read a comic book?
No.
Do you even nerd?
He doesn't nerd. He's too cool for school.
That's from a...
Everybody hates me.
You got another very polite rejection letter.
Collect them, yeah. Paint them on your wall. You'll have wallpaper for your entire house in no time.
Like, try to be a writer. No one ever tries to hire a writer because they all do it themselves.
That is true.
They try to.
Exactly. That's something I've noticed. Oh God. Oh God. Stacy's mom. He's got it going.
What if Stacy's mom was Jesse's girl and her number was 867-5309?
Holy shit. I'm using that. I'm using that as a post. Jesus Christ. That's too funny. Holy shit. Doc, how did you,
man, see, that's something somebody should draw.
My brain just works that way, Rich. I can't even.
$50, and I'll do it.
Every once in a while, it just vomits.
What's up, Doc? What's cooking?
What's up, Doc?
Every 6 or 7 weeks, my brain spits out a good idea.
Right on schedule.
Just vomits it right out of there. And I'm like, I gotta write it down.
My light just went to shit on me.
It was good in the first place.
Okay, guys, I'd like you to meet a friend of mine. She's a very good friend. And she is also the co-organizer for Lux Events here in the United Kingdom. Let's say hello to Amanda Marriott. Hey!
Hello, Amanda.
Hello, Amanda.
Hi, Amanda. Hello. Amanda, allow me to introduce this illustrious panel that you're here for. Hello. This is this gentleman over here, if I may, is longtime classical painter, comic book artist, and good friend, Christopher Doc Blaylock. Right over here, this gentleman over here is Quentin White, who is an aspiring cartoonist, just as much as I am.
How's it going?
Over here is my friend Max, who is the CEO and EIC of AtrocityPress.com. And last, but definitely not least, oh yeah, I got to get the kid, but that's later. this gentleman over here is the owner. This gentleman over here, this is Pops Van Zandt. He is the president of the Madness Comic Network.
Hello. You're currently on.
Hello.
Nice to meet you, Amanda.
Welcome. I like your nails.
Welcome to the Madness.
Ah, thanks. Welcome to the Madness. All ready for next week?
Yeah, we're going to have some fun with that one. Amanda, tell everyone all about you. Please do so.
Oh my gosh, where do we start?
And wherever you want to. Wherever you want to start, my dear. Go get them, Tiger.
Well, so as Rich says, we've got Big Shy Comic Con next weekend in my hometown of Clee Forbes. I'm very excited. Mm-hmm. Looking forward to it. So we've been in the Comic Con world for about 5 or 6 years now. And then I've been running them personally for 2 to 3. It all started out, it's just madness. Absolutely love it all. Love the madness.
we like the madness also.
Absolutely. Okay, done.
We're just going to have to bring you all the way in. Okay.
We're going to have to bring you all the way in.
You have to join the Comic Related Madness on Facebook and post about your event, because we have members from all over the world. We have a bunch of friends in the UK. Rich knows.
Yeah, we do.
Come into the Madness Facebook group and tell everybody about it. You know, drop a promo for your con, when it is, where it is, so that the people in that area can go.
And you know I'm gonna share it, Amanda, if you want. I'll share it all the time if you need me to. I'd be more than happy.
Appreciated. You've already done far too much as it is, bless you.
Oh, please,
so
don't be silly.
What's the, like, how many people do you usually get at your car? I mean, what's the size of it?
So we're running from quite a small leisure center, but last year we managed to get in over 1,800 through the doors within the 2 days.
Wow.
That's good.
That's real good.
We are hoping the weather holds off, fingers crossed, and we can do it again.
That's more than that imaginary con that happened in Arizona, right, Bob? I'm sorry. That just came falling out of my mouth.
What happened? I don't even know.
No, we're not going there. We're not.
Has nothing to do with anyone on stream right now. My apologies.
Arizona isn't real.
All jokes accepted. I was just taking a shot at somebody
Arizona
who's
real.
Very deserving of shots having taken out.
Oh my god.
Oh dear.
Doc was stirring. Doc picked up the wooden spoon and started stirring.
I'm sorry.
That's what happened.
So what all do you do? when it comes to the convention, Amanda? I mean, you're the organizer?
Yes. So, yeah, myself and my husband, Peter, we run them together. So everything from booking guests, booking artists, tables, traders, attractions, props, everything. Absolutely.
Nice. Very nice.
Do you want to go through, aside from me, do you want to go through a guest list of who's going to show up at your show this coming weekend?
Absolutely. Although, you know, we've got a star guest here already, yourself.
Yeah, I'm all right.
We've also got guest artists, Lee Bradley and Sonia Leong.
Okay, excellent. Cool. I know who Sonia is. She's awesome.
Yeah, Sonia's lovely, bless her. She's so awesome. She is. And obviously we've got Lee as well. He's another really good drawer, artist, mm-hmm.
Driver, artist, driver. I'm sorry. Don't hit me.
You like my drawings?
I'm off.
Stop. I don't want to stop. Stop. Stop now. Stop now. Oh my God.
Stop me now.
That's racist.
That is racist.
Racist.
I thought I was the racist here.
You know, right,
that's only against the town.
Don't speak. Do not speak, child. Do not speak.
Do not speak.
Dude, language. My God. How did we meet? Amanda, how did we meet?
No longer.
I met you at Paul's show, didn't I?
What?
How did we meet?
Yeah, we met at Paul's show.
We did. We met, was it about 4 years ago, maybe something like that? 4 or 5 years ago?
That was like more about two, I think. Either 2 or 3.
Was it 2 or 3?
I think it was something like that, yeah.
It's better than how I meet my friends. I just randomly call people on the phone and just say, like, hey, you want to buddy up and go get a drink? Because she's the same.
Max.
That's what you do. That's how you meet people.
Did you guys meet at a con before COVID shut everything down?
Yeah.
Okay. So at least 3 years ago.
Yes, about 3 years ago.
Okay. Yeah. I'm just trying to establish.
She's had to put up with Rich ever since.
Oh my God. Thankfully, not that much. I try not to punish anybody that for that long.
And we do know a bunch of people in the UK that are, you know, artists that are part of the group. Arya and Nick and Lucifer, and I could go on. David Brace. There's a bunch of people over there, either in the Netherlands, like Q, in England. I mean, we got a bunch of people. Some of them you might already even know. You never know. But definitely want to promote what you're doing so that, you know, like next year, maybe they want to be part of your con.
Absolutely. We've got plans on doing more Comic-Cons as well, but not just in my area. We have just signed a new contract for another area as well.
Where's that going to be?
Yeah. It'll be in Lincolnshire.
Okay.
I've actually heard of that city.
Yep. So we shall be there, and we're planning obviously doing a couple more. So we're always looking for artists and guests and things like that who might want to join us, and traders, props, everything. The more we can get, the better, I think.
Do you have a website for your company?
We do. We have our website, which is Lux Events UK, or we do have Facebook and Instagram, which is Beachside Comic Con, or again, Lux Events.
Beachside Comic Con.
Beachside, yes, sir.
Beachside Comic Con, yes, exactly. Beachside, because we are literally right next to the beach. You can walk out the venue and onto the beach.
Is it really a beach if it's always raining?
If it's always raining, did you say?
Yeah. Isn't that a British thing?
Dude.
It's always raining. Always.
That's racist.
That never stops. It just keeps coming.
It's like a virus. Our lovely, esteemed guest, continuous audience member, Carrie, grew up in Lincolnshire, it sounds like.
Yeah.
He holds Osmond Ransom. He says when he was. Wow, okay. That's, God help me with this. So, Amanda, I want to show you something.
Go for it.
Almost done.
Oh, it's looking epic.
Yes. I cannot wait to finish this. I'm going to ink do you want me to, I think we talked about it before. I'm going to ink this at the show, correct?
Yes. I think you said you was going to ink it at the show, yes.
Yeah, so I'll ink it at the show. I'll ink this baby at the show, and I'll digitally ink it at some other point, and I'll just ink it traditionally for the show when it gets here, and I got to add a whole bunch more special effects and all that stuff. But yeah, I'm excited about this. Thank you for that. Thank you for inviting me. I will be blunt and honest. Thank you
so much. Thanks for thinking of me.
Thanks for thinking of me. Yes, exactly.
Yeah, you say you're looking for people to come. You get me a plane ticket and a hotel room.
and a
free table, I'll be there. I will be there quick as hell.
I'll keep that in mind.
right there, Beachside Comic Con. There's the
that's the one.
Facebook page right there. Check it out. Talk to look for you. Go look. Go check it out.
who's all in the picture there?
Well, I seen her right in the middle. I know that was right in the middle. But it's already gone. So
when's this happening?
So next weekend, the 23rd of July.
So do you have a lot of cosplayers and stuff that come? Or is it mostly comic centric?
Yeah, absolutely. There's loads of cosplayers. We have our own cosplay team as well, who are absolutely fantastic. And we do have a lot of people turn up in cosplay. People are so imaginative and what they wear. And I love to see people's creativities in the costumes.
Yeah. That's one of the cool things. It's like going to Comic-Con and just, you can see, you know, it's like, I'll just use this as an example. Bender the Robot. I've seen people that do cardboard boxes surrounded by aluminum.
Aluminium.
I'm sure you get lots of steampunk, lots of Doctor Who, lots of that.
I've seen people that do like 3D printed everything to where it fits their arm perfectly and they can move there. They actually have range of motion and everything. And, you know, it gets crazy. Those people put a lot of effort into that stuff.
There's so many different materials you can use. So you can 3D print it. There's something what we call like evil foam, which is which you can bend and ply with heat. And you can paint. And you've got warbler, which is slightly thicker, more durable. And then obviously everything else in between. People's imaginations and creativity is just amazing. It really is.
Yeah. So do you have cosplay contests and stuff like that?
An under 12s and over 12s cosplay contest both days. And cool. They are amazing looks cosplay team. They handle all that. But yeah, they are really fabulous. And they're holding their own cosplay panel this year as well.
Awesome.
I'm
not a cosplayer or anything, but I'm a big cosplay fan. I like collecting cosplay covers when it comes to comic books. I like talking to the people who are doing their cosplay, unless they're in character. You know, I don't want to just destroy their what do they call it?
Persona.
Their role play.
I don't want to mess up their role play. So.
You find most people do generally like to talk about the characters in that anyway.
Yeah.
Ask away. Might as well.
I mean, there was one that, I ran into this one guy who was a stormtrooper, and he had it.
You missed him.
He had it down. He had the little, the helmet was on with the, had the microphone with the little speaker that was hidden in his helmet. So it sounded like he was actually talking through the little radio thing that they had. It was pretty cool.
Some of the outfits are just amazing. They really are. Yeah.
People put a lot of work into it.
I truly appreciate cosplay when there's time taken into account to it. When it's like there's so much intricacy and right down to minutiae detail with anything like that, it really, a lot of cosplay that I've seen looks better than some of the costumes that are sewn together at movie studios.
Yeah, I guess what I always say, like, half this cosplay looks better than the stuff you see in a movie about this character.
Yeah, Amanda's is spectacular.
Budget they have compared to the budget these guys have is ridiculous.
Yeah.
Yes, it is.
Who do you really cosplay?
Can you imagine having a movie budget, like your share of that movie budget to make your cosplay costume? Can you imagine how much better you could make what you already make?
Oh, that would just be amazing. I'd probably end up making about 10 of them, to be honest.
and the thing is, that money that they use in that movie, come on, you know, too much of that has to just be given back in kickbacks to different producers and stuff. Because they're not putting that much money into these costumes.
No, a lot of them monetize.
Yeah, I know when we was at one of the shows speaking to one of the ladies who was a widow sister in the film Black Widow. She was saying
the
costume cost about, I think it was at least $1,000 just for one.
Wow. Damn. Good God.
So, and that's not everything else as well. That's just literally just like the basics.
Who do you cosplay as?
So I'm mainly known as Widow, because I cosplay Black Widow quite a lot. So my nickname is Widow. But I cosplay all sorts of things. So one of my favorite ones is myself and Peter do Jumanji. So Shelley Overone and Ruby Roundhouse.
Yep.
Absolutely, it's one of my favorites.
Nicely done.
And then we've got a full team of Turtles, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles as well.
That's awesome.
You also have Ghostbusters there, don't you?
We do. We've just built an X-01 Ghostbusters car, proper car.
What? Yes! Built one? Are you serious?
Yeah, it's sat on my front.
Woo!
Do you want me to show you?
Yes!
Of course.
Right, we're here.
That's not even a question. Come on now.
Absolutely.
Woo! Hey, nerds, would you like to see Ecto-1?
See a real life Ecto-1.
This is an exclusive right here, right now.
Sorry, I don't know if we can... It's raining.
Oh, dang. Very cool.
Yep.
Very nice, very nice.
It's and perfect. She likes and sounds as well.
Nice.
That's crazy.
So, yeah, that's our new baby.
It's got the proper wee-er, has it got its own different...
Absolutely.
Sound? Nice.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Makes all the noises, flashes. We've got a bit more to do to it, but a lot has already been done. So we did a prom a couple of weeks ago.
Very cool.
So how many Ghostbusters do you have?
We have 3 Ghostbusters in a minute, and I'm working on one of the lady Ghostbusters myself as well.
Cool. Yeah, I mean, there's at the horror convention here, that's it was either this weekend or last weekend, maybe next weekend, I don't know, I don't go anymore. They have a Ghostbusters union. You know, / union. And they all get together just to drink, but they're all in Ghostbusters costumes. There's like 40 guys and girls in Ghostbusters uniforms with their backpacks and everything. And they're really into the cosplay. You know, it's not like they're just crap costumes that they just bought. These people put these things together. They built their own...
Proton packs
and everything, and they all look awesome. And they just sit around and hang out, and as a Ghostbusters union.
Yeah, it's absolutely fantastic. And some of those pieces as well, some of them actually handmade proton packs as well.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. They made the proton packs.
That's crazy. Again, all that detail you put in, that's just astonishing.
Had 2 weeks to do it.
Wow. Two weeks.
2 weeks. So we started off with the blank car. So we put on all the vinyls and all the top was built and made and put all together.
It takes me 2 weeks just to get dressed.
It does into one of the costumes with all the packs and everything on. It takes about 2 weeks. So, yeah.
So. If you'll allow me a minute, I'm going to send you the picture.
I'm done with it, Amanda.
Yeah, I finished this. Now I just got to ink it. But I'm probably going to put more detail in here. But for all intents and purposes, it's done. Oh, sorry.
Oh, man. Okay.
Ink.
Where was I? Okay. Now, is this the first one? Is this the first one, the first beachside, or is this the second or the third?
This is the second one.
Second one?
Yeah. Making a return. Yeah, but advance
sales. How is your advance sales for the second one? Do you have any advance sales for the second?
They're absolutely flying out the window this week.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, the sales were good anyway, but this week, it's been amazing.
Obviously, we still beat that 1800 from last year, right?
I mean, I'm hoping we're going to smash it. I'm pretty sure we will.
Cool. Nice.
1800 for a first year con is really good.
Yeah.
That is good.
And right now, cons are doing well, especially your range of the middle level con.
Yes.
Because a lot of people have been trapped in the house with COVID, and they're still scared about going to large conventions, but they'll go to smaller events.
Yeah, I mean, some of the larger ones, don't get me wrong, they can book the big names. Like, I know Helena Bonecart has just been booked for a Comic-Con, which is a great name. But coming with that is a lot of people. A lot of people, which is to be expected.
Yeah.
They've worked their way up there and, you know, they've done well to get there. But I think it's the smaller cons as well that really kind of help level it out, I think.
I think so, too.
I do better at smaller cons than I do at bigger cons.
Yeah.
Too many people. Too much claustrophobic, I think.
Well,
with
indies, you're competing against too much. You know, the big
guys.
I got to
get my autograph from whichever Power Ranger there is, because there's one at literally every con.
Yeah. I'm just saying, it's like there's too many distractions at the big con. You could walk right by a table and not even realize you walked by it because you were looking at somebody else's cosplay as you were walking.
Yeah.
And totally miss something. You know, it's like there's so many look squirrel moments at a big con. You don't have time to back through a second time and look at everything. You know what I mean? It's like you're going to get one chance. And if you get distracted while you're walking, you're going to miss something. You know, them tables ain't that big.
What we try to do as well is obviously because I've got children, so I know what it's like going out with kids, so we do try and do a lot of things for the kids as well. So we have got like free face painting and glitter tattoos for them. We've got a free magic show for them, and we've got other bits and bobs so they can do some badge making and sand art and stuff and that as well. So
put some Max on the reach for that. Because you need to put Rich into that if he gets bored, just in case.
Yeah, just send him off to get some face painting.
God. I got to be painted up as the Ultimate Warrior. I don't know who I would be painted up as.
Chef
God.
Boyardee?
No, the Ultimate Warrior would be great. Do it all in glitter.
With that hair right now, you're definitely...
I would do it in glitter. I would have my face painted in glitter. I would allow.
I mean, we can maybe arrange that.
All right.
With that hair, just paint him green. He's the whole...
Yeah, just green. Yeah.
Look
at this. You believe this hair? This hair's gone too damn wild for its own good. Ooh, Amanda, you're going to like this one. I'm going to send it to you. I'll show it to you. Giggle, giggle, tee-hee. I'm excited. I am super excited. From what happened lately, as a result of the writers and the actors strike over here in the United States, that doesn't affect you in any way, because most if not all the actors are, you know, the British actors and all that are off the chairs.
So it's not affected us. Unfortunately, obviously, it has affected a couple of the people we know in the industry. So their work has been cancelled. I think it's a very much grey area. So with the, obviously with the strikes, they're not allowed to work. However, I have seen somewhere that they are still able to attend Comic-Cons, but they're just not allowed to do any guest panels or talk about anything that they might be working on or.
Yeah, they can't talk about their characters.
I have a hard time with that phrase, allowed.
Yeah.
Yeah. But they can talk about other stuff that they've done in the past. So,
yeah,
you know, you get Ernie Hudson in there. You could talk. You can't talk about what he's doing now, but you can talk about him in Ghostbusters or The Crow, or whatever. So,
yeah, as long as they're not seen to be promoting any work that they're doing at the minute or future work, anything else you can talk about and chat about.
I need coffee. I'll be right back.
I'm also not allowed to do a Spider-Man print, but doesn't stop anyone at cons. I swear.
No.
Marvel really, I mean, I can tell you something about that. If you've actually worked for Marvel, it's not that big of a deal if I do it. You know, if you don't work for Marvel, as long as you're not making over an X amount of dollars per show and it's noticed, Disney or, Marvel never used to really care about it because as far as they're concerned, it's free advertising. You know, it's free promoting, you know, because it's like, what's a 10-pound print or a $10 print? It's nothing. You know, I mean, if whatever you can get, if there's an artist who can get it, that's great. You know, whatever it is, it is. You know, it's just that if you're taking material or any of the art and you're reproducing it that was for a promotional piece or an advertisement or something, first off, that's plagiarism. And then second, you can get zapped. You definitely get zapped on that one. So it's a gray area, but
that's why everybody does mashups.
That's exactly.
That way they can get around copyright laws with mashups. You know, you do Spider-Man and Rick and Morty.
Oh God, Spider Morty.
They suck.
They don't suck. Rick and Morty doesn't suck. The
Spider-Man
guy who was
Rick and Morty does though.
Ugh, God, Spider-Man, Rick and Morty. Yeah, I've seen a bunch of those. I've seen one where it's like somebody managed to put every single Power Ranger that has ever existed on the planet Earth into one big giant print, and I'm just like, how the hell do you do something like that?
You get George Perez to do it.
Yeah, that's right. Get George Perez, the ghost of George Perez, to do it.
Yeah, yes.
God, bloody hell, man.
Not this one. Not this.
No, not that one. Not that one at all.
I think George Perez he was a great artist, but his mutant ability was spatial management. Mm-hmm. That dude. Yes. Jesus Christ, man. Yeah. I need 45 people in this 3-inch by 5-inch panel. No problem.
All right, sure.
I got it to the point where you can even see the detail and tell them apart.
Yeah. Yeah.
I could? Oh, my God.
That's what got me.
So, yeah. Let me, give me a moment. I just showed Amanda, and I wanted to show her first. So give me a moment.
I see how it is, Rich. I see how it is.
What are you talking about, dude?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
Okay. Too many Skittles.
I know.
Taste rainbow.
Okay, one second. Amanda, may I share this?
Go for it.
All right, here we go.
Yeah.
I knew you were going to say it, Doc.
No.
You haven't said that in a while. Honeycomb's got a big, big bite.
Big bite.
Boom. Ta-da.
Lover.
I just did that.
Looks good. I like that.
Thanks, man.
So, Rich, you're going to be there?
I will be there both days, and I will be inking this at the show live, and this is going to go in a raffle, right, Amanda?
It is, yeah. Yeah, so we're going to raffle it off with on our cosplay table. Yeah.
So are we going to get you? Are we going to get you as a live remote on the show next week?
Most likely.
Yeah, we can try.
We can try. I mean,
the internet on the phone will probably not be the best, but give it a shot.
Well, I'm going to bring my laptop anyway, and if there's an issue with Wi-Fi, I can always hotspot my phone, so it's not going to be a big deal.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. Use one phone for a hotspot, the other one to broadcast. But if you got your laptop, use your phone for a hotspot, use your laptop to broadcast.
Well, I mean, this just depends because, like, when if there's too many people in one spot and it's all like they're all T-Mobile, it's going to be hitting that T-Mobile tower and it's going to ping it out, and they're not going to have enough. You're going to start having dropped.
I'm sure we'll
sucks in general.
I'll make sure that I share it at some point. I definitely will.
But I mean, definitely try for sure. I mean, it could work. I've seen it work with a lot of
worked all day for us in Savannah.
Yeah, honestly, I've seen it like some mid-sized cons. I've seen it work, but when you get into something like New York Comic Con or something like that, and you just got like 180,000 people in one space, you know, they don't have any repeaters, and you're just going to lose your phone capability to even make calls or send text messages or definitely hotspot it. Because everyone's going to be hotspotting their phone.
You just got to make sure your con video is better than me and Tom's from Indiana Comic Con.
I'm glad that your show is the size of the show that it is, because I when I moved back to New York in 2014, before I moved here, I went to the New York Comic Con like 3 years running, and it just kept on getting more populated as the years went. I mean, when I went in 2014, I think it had 175,000.
Yep.
All together. Yeah. And then now it's at, I don't know if it, did it reach 200K max?
No, it dropped down.
Oh, it did.
Okay. Yeah. COVID, it got close. It was at 185 was the highest it got, the highest attendance it got. And then COVID happened. And then the first couple of years, first year was like 165. And the second year was like 180, so they're definitely moving back up towards hitting that 200,000.
Dang,
people in attendance.
So damn big, it's not even funny. It's
in the Javits, and they use the whole thing. Yep. I mean,
the
come
whole
on.
Damn Javits Center. The convention center is literally the size of a small town. It's just that damn big. It's not a joke. I think that takes up at least 10 full city blocks on the West End Highway.
Yeah.
Easily.
People telling me that, if you... He has an intern that he has come with him, so he can have somebody sit at his table when he has to go pee, because he goes, dude, it takes you 45 minutes to go take a piss. Because you got to go there, stand in line, take a piss, then finally get out and come back to your table. And walking through all those people, it just slows you down. There's nothing. There's no way around it.
Yeah, I'm not a huge fan of all those large conventions because it's almost impossible to get any type of contact with them. You see, the shows that are the size of yours, Amanda. Yeah. Those are the ones that are great because you can meet with every single person there within a 2 day span.
Everybody that just stops at your table, you can talk to. Yeah,
exactly.
You're not being pushed along by the crowd behind them.
That's true. That's another thing that's true. If there's way too many people in the show, if there's way too many people attending the show, it's almost like a continuous wave, and it's impossible for anybody to stop.
Yeah, agree.
I'm excited to go to your show. I cannot wait.
We're looking so forward to it. Can't wait.
Hi, Dawn.
Hello, Dawn.
Dawn, this is my friend Amanda Marriott, and she is the co-owner of Lux Events. And she is the person who invited me to go to Beachside Comic Con this weekend over at Gleethorpe's, which is about a good 2 hours away from where I live.
Well, nice to meet you.
Lovely to meet you.
Have you decided what you're going to cosplay these 2 days, Amanda?
Well, see, it's the only time I don't cosplay is when I'm running events.
There you go. Oh. I'm working. I'm not playing. I get it. Yeah. I get it.
Not playing. She is not playing.
Yeah. Although I am
going to
Rich, Carol has a question for you, Rich.
How much do I pay Amanda to be my friend? More than I would pay you.
What's up, Carol?
Hi, Carol.
Hey, Carol.
Oh, Carol. Yeah, Carol's a duty face. That's what she is. Unbelievable.
$300 a day.
$300 a day. I'm expensive. I'm expensive. I am expensive.
I was referring to the other way around. You weren't expensive.
Ah, I have to pay someone $300. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
Believable. You see this disrespect? That's being polite. Amanda, thank you for showing up. I appreciate you being here. I appreciate you talking for a bit with us.
And I'm sorry, Rich didn't warn you. I'm sorry, Rich.
No, I was. Oh, I didn't have to warn you. You guys acted fine. You guys.
What do you think? I didn't come on from that non-season. I just got home.
This is one of our normal banners for this show.
Yeah.
I haven't even said F you once today. It's crazy.
I'm here, but we know it's gonna come out now.
Eventually.
I love the madness, don't worry about it.
We have disclaimers for this show and everything because
pull it up.
None of us have a filter. It's horrible.
It is horrible. Yeah, this is
wasn't for Doc keeping us in line, you know, with stuff like this.
Rich.
Thank God.
Poor
Rich.
I'm gonna sneak up and blast him.
Okay, I can't tag you. I can't tag you. I'm gonna see you Friday, man.
Yeah, God, you think we were mad at you, and you know it.
I know.
We show our love in a strange way towards you.
I know. Everybody shows me love in a very strange, peculiar way.
That's what the priest said. Who's the priest?
You see what I mean? You see what I mean, Amanda? That's
there. It is.
Fanta! There's another one of our friends.
Fanta, darling.
Fanta!
If we didn't pick on Rich, he would think we were mad at him. And it's sometimes the thing that keeps us going.
Much. Am I going to see? I'll see you Friday. I'll let you know what time I'm going to come in. All right, Amanda?
Absolutely. Let us know. We'll pick you up.
All right. Guys, everybody say goodbye to Amanda in the nicest way possible, please.
Nice. Bye, Amanda. Amanda. Thanks for coming.
Bye.
Peace.
Bye.
Bye. Rich, make sure you get her into madness. Make sure she starts promoting that con.
I will. You know. I shall. I'm going to change my camera for a minute, and I'll be right back.
Because that's what we do, is we promote people. Yes. Fantish, that lady that just left, Amanda, she runs a Comic-Con in the UK. Right there. That right there. It's next weekend. It's this coming weekend. Next weekend, whatever. If you want to help promote that a little bit to our UK friends, you know what I'm saying.
So that means Rick was going to be here next weekend, right?
Oh, he'll probably still make a remote cameo.
I'll make a cameo. I'll make a cameo.
I have to try and talk to run in the show next week.
Now we can get poor.
You notice he totally ignored me, right?
Wait, what?
Let me run the show.
Sorry, I'm working.
Tadpole walked over you, and I talked over you, and I didn't hear what you said. Thanks, Tadpole.
I'm.
They didn't call a tadpole for
for no reason.
I'm hoping we can get Doc to run the show next week since Rich will be at a con.
I should be able to do that.
I was hoping so. We'll have Q. We'll have Doc and Q run the show next week.
You know, I'm not doing it without Q. I'm just saying.
There you go.
Doc's just gonna ban me constantly.
Handshake for Doc.
And of course, it'd be just like any other open draw stream. You guys know everybody's invited. Come on out. Vic, are you drawing something? Or are you just bothering us?
He's bothering my phone's dying. I'm charging it for a second before I get back. Okay. I'm just drawing my
Yes. That, I dropped that in the stream yard. It went everywhere. It went everywhere.
Give me 1 second.
Yeah.
I'm having to draw a guy kicking it everywhere.
And yeah, that's cool. I love meeting people that run cons and stuff, especially, come on, man. We have a lot of friends that do stuff in the UK that are in the UK. We could help that grow.
UK, am I right?
Yes, the United Kingdom. Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Yeah. British people, they scare me.
Dude.
Yeah, you realize it's one of your ancestors, right?
One of the weird things about doing this multi-destination thing is StreamYard is if we drop a post in StreamYard itself, it goes everywhere. Okay, so it looks like Doc said it, and you know, but it's like it's the same post. I just put it in the StreamYard instead of going to each individual.
Thank you. Those aren't my ancestors. The British treated my ancestors like crap.
One of them. Not specifically, but one of them.
Hello.
Could How did you get out of the basement? Look, yeah. What the hell?
Y'all bring attention to that. Then he notices.
Hello, Carol Love.
Hello.
Hello, Stinky Face.
Hello, Duty Head.
Did you see
Duty Head?
Said, hi, Carol, how'd you get out the basement? He looked up. He's like,
he's like, oh, shit.
Surprise. Going to the cops.
Surprise, mother.
I know you did, Fendi. You were having a blast over there. It was so cool watching you and Hen and everybody getting to get together. Even when you got to meet Rich, I guess, was cool.
Cool.
You met Fanta in person?
Yes.
I did meet Fanta. Yeah, I did.
Poor Fanta. I feel for her.
Why would you feel for her?
Because life is all about
working out. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm gorgeous. I don't know what you're talking about. Yes, you got because I'm beautiful.
I got a slap in the Rich.
Not my fault that Carol's not adequately pretty enough.
Careful, dude. Be nice. Damn it.
I am being nice.
It's the 69th episode, Rich.
Be careful. Your hair's worse than mine.
It's the 69th episode, Rich. You're going to be all by yourself. You keep it up.
Nice. Nice.
I am. Go ahead.
Nice. Fine, Rex.
Nice.
Cool.
Rich and I meeting video is still on my channel.
Good stuff, dude.
I who did I draw? Chris Cornell.
Yeah. That rock and roll dude.
Yeah, Chris Cornell. That was a nice
draw. Chris Cornell for her.
That was actually a fucking awesome drawing too. It really was.
Man, I appreciate you saying that, man. Thank you. That does mean a lot. I appreciate that. I'm glad I was able to give it to Fanta, because I sure as hell wasn't going to spend the money for the the postage would have actually cost more than if that drawing was for commission.
No, see, we could have fixed that though. Anytime you were sending something to RJ, you just send it there, and he'd send it out because she buys stuff that he ends up shipping to her anyway.
Hey,
it's the bad part.
Any of you guys ever met Pablo Smarcos?
No.
Ooh, what?
He did Iron Jaw the Barbarian at Atlas Comics.
No.
Just making up.
No. I think he's making things up.
When you gave her a book to read. Hey, Belly.
Here we are.
Gave her a book to.
A book.
Be right back.
Yeah.
I
gave her. I think. I don't know if it was chapter one or chapter two. It might have been. Oh, speaking of which, I'm on the 8th page of Colors for Roaring.
Oh, goody.
Yeah. I color a page of Roaring every day.
Cool.
Nice.
I color a page of Roaring every single day. You know, which I'm going to get the coloring. I'm sorry?
What?
Sorry. But which chapter you're on?
Oh, the first issue of the Roaring that I was supposed to do last year. With unforeseen circumstances, wasn't able to do it. But now that I'm not going to return to class until late September, as a matter of fact. So the first issue of Roaring will finally be done. It'll be done in August, and then it'll be all sent out.
We're going to be stuck with you for that.
It's awful.
It is awful. It's terrible. I drew it. That's why it's terrible. If only Carol was able to draw it, then she'd do better than I would.
Carol can draw.
Carol can draw anything.
Carol can color, too.
Listen, I like Rich's work. I just don't like him as a person, you know?
I don't blame you. I'm a terrible human being.
You are an awful human.
I am an awful human.
Oh, there you go, Rich. Put her on.
I got to take off.
You'll have to send me one to cosplay. No, I will at some point, Amanda. I will.
Amanda's still watching us pick on Rich now. Uh-oh.
Bullying.
I got to take off. So okay, I'll talk to you guys later.
It is nice to see Max. Y'all can catch Max every Friday morning on the Madness Gaming Tomb of Annihilation, where he tries to kill me and my friends.
It's hotter than hell in my studio.
Many of you. Play D&D and you're free on Friday morning between 10 and 1 Eastern. We need a wizard to join our group really, really bad. Or the big baddie at the end is going to waste us.
Do you need a bard, Chris, perhaps?
Did he say bard?
Yes, I always play a bard. I am a dragonborn bard in my current bard.
I don't know if a bard would be enough to help us.
It's called a human shield.
Yeah, but you know.
You're kind of like your Bella in Twilight, your shield.
Oh. Kind of like.
Phantom, maybe like while I'm on vacation, I will draw you a Chris Cornell.
Cronky.
It'll be better than mine.
You see what my crew says.
I think Carol's, I think Carol's Chris Cornell is going to be better than mine. What do you think, Carol? Do you agree with me?
I don't know what yours looks like, but yeah, probably.
Doc, what are you working on? Show us.
Just a page.
That's not Doc. That's Quint.
He said, "Just a page." I'm trying to get him up there. Hold up. He's like, "Okay."
It is.
Oh, that's the one you started on when we were talking yesterday.
Yesterday. My private investigator is actually doing investigations. So, yeah.
Harry,
it's hot in here.
Yeah, I'm sure I'll have time to do something for you, Fanta, because I'm sure he's going to get annoyed with me.
80s or 90s.
Go away for a minute.
No, with you, Carol. Never do that.
Not you. Talking about
you. Oh, fine. Whatever.
Harry, were you ever able to get a warrior secret?
Wait, what?
What?
Who's secret? Harry's been wanting to get a copy of Warrior Secret, and it's finally available at Barnes & Noble, but I don't know if she was able to get a copy.
Harry, she's talking to Harry. Did you get a copy of Warrior Secret? Because it is now available on Barnes & Noble.
The Warrior Secret.
What's the secret?
I don't know. What's the secret?
You have to read the book to find out.
Well, maybe I don't want to read the book. Maybe I just want to know what the secret is.
You have to read the book.
Well, then you're never going to know.
Can't read.
Well, we know that you have issues.
Who's sleeping their coffee?
Look at this ADHD. He's illiterate.
I am not illiterate.
You just said
I am not illiterate, there, child.
That is the definition of illiteracy. You can't read.
Gary, you can order it online through Barnes & Noble.
They don't have a Barnes & Noble in the UK. We don't, actually. We don't have a Barnes & Noble in the UK. Or do we?
Is it available through the website, Dawn, for Michaela?
It is, but she would send it out to her directly. I think what other
Amazon?
No, not on Dawn.
Well, fine then.
Well, it is on.
No, no, no.
Calzones.
Calzone, what the fuck?
What is wrong with that kid?
He's high, that's all I know.
What?
Hey, okay. Has anybody over there heard of a website called waterstones.com?
No.
In the zone?
Who?
Carol, you're not in the UK, so she wasn't asking you.
She said anybody.
Anybody over there.
She's going to be where they sent all the criminals, so does it really matter? Isn't that what Australia is?
Fuck me, man. How did that happen?
What?
I lost a layer.
How many?
Like 5.
Dang.
God damn it. How does that happen?
I don't know.
Well, now I can't go back in and fix anything on that panel.
Ruh-roh.
Ruh-roh.
Can we see what you're working on? And no. You can't fix the panel?
No.
I can't show that page.
No is the answer. No.
Why is no the answer?
I'm not allowed to show the page.
Maybe Doc's afraid because his art's not.
It's not great. Doc's.
Because
whose art is it then?
It's Dillard's art for Artifice Reanimate.
Artifice Reanimate.
Oh. Fuck you.
No, never.
Thank God.
What about Andrew Tate?
God, exactly. God.
Damn it.
Dildo team.
I don't know if it's
so dildo funny. Team. Did someone say dildo team?
Dildo team.
No.
Okay.
Son of a bitch.
Damn, motherfucker.
Doc, I blame you.
I accept the blame.
All right.
Why do you accept the blame?
Because I'm Doc.
I don't have any other versions of this. Lie. Damn it. Well, I guess they're going to have to love this panel.
They better.
If I drop an ISBN number for, I know that's mainly for the U.S., but is that worldwide?
I'm so sorry. I forgot to mute Sharpening.
How dare you?
Gary, why are you going in hospital for, Carrie?
What?
What are you going in hospital for, Carrie? You going to be all right?
I'm looking at water stones done when I'm out of hospital. What the heck are you doing in a hospital?
Oh, no. It's going to be something completely mundane.
Oh, hi, Gary.
I don't know what color his pants are.
Oh, it's dying again. I hate this freaking phone.
We have to plug it in.
Plug it. Get to the charger.
I hate you.
What?
Oh.
Oh, goodness.
Oh, no.
Why would you do that?
Yeah.
Gary, why in the hell would you do something like that? Oh, boy. Somber.
Shit.
We always hear you talk, sweetheart.
Yeah, we are. We all are.
Absolutely.
Yeah, please. Please.
Yeah, even me.
If that's really that way, please talk to any of us.
Carrie, I understand. It feels like we're overwhelmed. Too much is too much. Peace out. But there's always going to be a brighter tomorrow.
Yeah, that's the truth.
Feel free to reach out.
Yeah, please do. Please do.
Didn't they beat the White Sox yesterday, though, Billy?
Who?
Braves and White Sox were playing. I think it was yesterday. Braves won that one. But I haven't even seen a Braves game this year, Billy, to be honest with you. And not for lack of trying. I'm always busy.
I don't get baseball.
Baseball's only fun if you're.
I don't think you've ever played sports. Have you ever actually played sports, Tadpole?
Yes.
But Ben doesn't count. Jesus.
I can play baseball.
You can?
I can hit that ball so fucking good. You have no idea.
Baseball really? Is the
greatest sport ever in the history of man.
No, that's ice hockey, but go on.
No, it's not. Ice hockey is
Jesus Christ.
The greatest sport in the history of man is basketball.
No, right, it's ice hockey.
It's not.
I'm going to tell all of you to shut your blowholes. Stop talking over me.
I like golf.
It's a national pastime. It's like you never had an apple pie.
All right,
dude, you don't
on,
live Doc. In the United States. What are you talking about?
All right, y'all shut up. Doc is talking.
Go,
we're going to get Meyer Raskin's cut.
You people done spurging now?
No.
Baseball is the most strategic game
it
out
is.
There. It is. If you really boil it down to it, it is mm-hmm. the psychology of the catcher, the pitcher, the batter, and the umpire. Everything else is just lanyap.
Mental chess.
That's right.
If you That's ever up. Go back and you watch Greg Maddux at his best when he's stretching the strike zone mm-hmm. 1 millimeter at a time to convince the batters that it's a ball, but he's convincing the umpire it's a strike. I mean, he and Glavin both were just steely-eyed missile men that fucked with people's minds, and it was amazing to watch.
You're a Braves fan. How did that feel to have Tom Glavin win his 300th game as a New York Met?
Well, not good, but I remember this. When it was Glavin, Smoltz, Avery, and Maddux.
They were the
most feared pitching staff Jesus in the Christ. History of baseball.
Yes.
Maddux is a surgeon.
There were major leaguers. They were like, yeah, we don't want to go to Atlanta. We don't want to play in Atlanta.
He never threw a no-hitter. Can you believe that?
Right. But
he never did. Greg Maddux never threw. Did Tom Glavin throw one?
Yeah. Yeah, more than
one. He threw one, but Greg Maddux never did. And as good as Tom Glavin was, Greg Maddux is superior.
My team can beat him.
Maddux, I never knew that. Maddux won more games, but Glavin won more big games.
Glavin,
if you go back and look, Glavin didn't even sweat. That dude was a machine.
He was a machine.
Steely-eyed missile man.
Yeah, he was absolutely incredible. Absolute Met killer. Him and Chipper Jones. Jesus Christ.
Think about all the great.
As a Met fan, I hated Chipper Jones.
Terry Pendleton, Otis Nixon.
Andrew Jones.
Oh, I love Terry Andrew Pendleton. Jones. He was great with the Cardinals too, man.
And this comes from my island.
Terry Pendleton was probably, to be a short little chubby guy, he was the quickest third baseman I think I ever saw.
One of them, yeah.
Quick.
Up there with Brooks Robinson. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Brooks Robinson, he was for the Orioles, I think. Yeah, he was one of the greatest third basemen of all time. Easily. Absolutely easily. But Terry Pendleton's up there. There was a lot of great players during that era.
Oh, man. A lot David of Justice.
The 90s, yeah.
Justice was good. He was good with the Braves. He was good with the Yankees. And he Otis got a Nixon. Little... I barely Otis remember Nixon. Otis Nixon. I barely remember him. I remember Dale Murphy.
Otis Nixon, well, that's going even back to the 80s. Otis Nixon is the one. Someone had hit one out. And a lot of people have climbed the walls. But Nixon ran sideways up the wall, digging his cleats into the mats. And he got to knee height level with the wall to snag a home run.
I got a home run. I got a home run. Oh, nope.
No, you don't. Nixon's out there. You ain't got shit.
I am not a crook.
No offense, but the Braves are one of my least favorite baseball teams, basically because when we beat them in the World Series in 91, there was a bunch of the Children's Hospital in up in Minneapolis. They had all these banners that they made up for these kids made these banners, and they hung them up in the studio for the Braves, the stadium. And during the game, the fans destroyed them and tore them down. And I thought that was very disrespectful to these kids that were dying.
But that was Minnesota fans that did that.
No, it was Braves fans.
No, it wasn't. No Braves fan ever set foot in Minnesota.
No, it happened in Atlanta. They sent those down to Atlanta.
Well, then that was a huge mistake. That was a huge mistake.
You're not mad because Minnesota won that series, are you, Doc?
No. I will, however, point out that was the when the game-winning run for the Braves that would have won the series. They said Pendleton did not touch third base, and the Jumbotron kept showing on replay his foot not only hitting the bag, but talc flying off of the bag from where he hit it repeatedly. We won. We won.
Oh, shut up, you beat my baby.
You lost.
So what is so weird is that I get to say, I now that I live in Peoria, it's like split between Cubs fans and Cardinal fans. And I get it always from the Cardinal fans that we shouldn't have won that series. We won that series. So I'm just used to that at this point.
All I know is that umpire bought a new house the next week.
Okay. Yeah.
The umpire bought a house.
He never touched third base. Yes, the fuck he did.
You know that talc isn't on the base. That's the chalk from
chalk, whatever.
You know that, right?
He hit the bag so hard that chalk flew off the bag.
Just hit a pile of chalk. One of
no, you can clearly see it. Go back and look it up, Pops.
Oh my God!
It's a championship in Minnesota.
It's not even vague. It is so overtly obvious.
What team do you like
in Minnesota? In one of the smallest markets in all of baseball, they won 2 World Series in 4 years.
Now, mind you, I like Minnesota. I liked Minnesota as a franchise.
That's because they don't try to buy players anymore. They don't grow good players anymore. They trade them away as soon as they get there. Shit, that team they had.
Just like they said in Moneyball. Like they said in Moneyball, you know, all we are is a farm team for the Yankees and the Red Sox.
Get her done.
That was a great movie.
It was a great movie. I do know this. No one was more surprised that the Braves put together that monster team of the 90s than I was. Because I was a Braves fan when the way you punished somebody was giving them tickets to a Braves game. You know?
The Braves always had the market to build a team. They always had the market to build a team. They just didn't.
Yep.
Yeah. Eric Gregg banned from the MLB for rigging games.
Really?
Yep.
I did not know that.
Minnesota built a team in their farm.
Shut up, Rich. You don't have anywhere to talk on baseball. Go play cricket.
Atlanta could not have bought a win in the 80s, except for the year they won the National League West with Rick Camp, Gene Garber. Well,
Minnesota grew that team in their farm system.
So did Atlanta.
Knobloch, all those guys Puckett. They all came out of their own farm system. They didn't buy that team.
Yeah, Atlanta had to build from scratch also after a 30-year losing streak. They just came out of nowhere, caught lightning in a bottle, and rode it for 10 years. It was amazing.
How many straight pennants did they
win? Basketball is
well, I don't remember, but it was pretty much a decade.
Yeah, it was a decade, that's for sure. And I think the only team to break it was the Phillies, like 1 year, and then the Braves went back to winning again.
And Vic, there's nobody on this panel that's going to agree with you that basketball is close to the best game there is.
Basketball is the best. You know why?
No, it's not. Period. There is no why.
Well, what you have to say about the Phillies? That's right. We kick your ass.
What about Philly steak?
Phillies suck.
Remember that most sports involve going back and forth, up and down some kind of grid with goals at each end, not baseball. Completely different.
Yeah.
Well, what kind of name is the team?
One going in the end is hockey.
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 No, it's not.
Hockey. Pussy. Hockey. I don't know about hockey.
It's not a game for pussies.
No, you say shit about hockey. Don't you? Billy says
the Braves won 14 straight division titles.
Jesus. Nice. God.
And I think it was 11 straight league titles. Nine.
What about roller derby thoughts?
I think roller derby is the greatest sport ever.
Especially
the topless roller derby. That was amazing.
Yes. More. Shut up.
Topless roller
lingerie derby. MMA. That's all I'm going to say.
Well, I mean, you remember the lingerie football league? A friend of mine's daughter played in that.
I'm going to win.
Holy shit.
It's really? Lingerie MMA, Doc. Just check it out. That's all I'm going to say.
I'm scared to put that in my search engine, Pops.
No, it's a real thing.
It is a real thing.
I'm scared to put it in my search engine.
A porn actress was an MMA fighter.
What about professional hobby horse racing?
Should I leave?
Oh my God. You saw that too?
Oh, my God.
Oh, Billy, by the way, speaking of, when the Braves won this last World Series, I didn't even know they had won it. I got disgusted and turned it off and said, I can't watch. And I woke up and the Braves had won. I was like, yes.
It's okay, a miracle.
Off the previous topic. Good.
What? That hockey's the best sport ever?
No.
Hockey's
hockey
is.
Figure skating with
no one cares. No one cares who won the Stanley Cup. What was it?
As long as it wasn't Pittsburgh, it doesn't matter. The last time
it was in Pittsburgh, that was Brian Trottier, I think, or whatever his name was. The Penguin guy? I don't know who it is. I don't care. Hockey is.
Hey, Pops, who was it that was telling us that NASCAR actually entered a NASCAR in 24 Hours of Le Mans?
James
Left turn. Oh, I got to look that up because they had to turn in more than one direction. That had to totally fuck up a NASCAR driver.
Nah, they race on road courses in NASCAR, dude.
Yeah, blah, blah, blah.
Left turn.
Blah, 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 blah.
Here's the reason I never got into NASCAR. I can go get on the perimeter around Atlanta and participate. I don't have to watch it.
Okay.
We go six wide at 200 miles an hour around Atlanta all the time.
Southern boys go moonshining or some shit like that.
If they wanted to impress me, they could make an actual stock car. You go to the dealership. You grab your sponsor's car. And you drive it. Yeah, That's how it used to be. It ain't no mo. I want to see
Some cars are better than others, and it was kind of a wash at some point.
Yeah, exactly. That's why I want to see it.
Nah.
This is the third year in a row Chevy has won. Well, no, it's not really even a Chevy anymore, is it?
It's a Chevy body on a who knows what.
It's an imitation Chevy body. Yeah, I mean,
no, it's
a Hyundai. That's what it was.
It's a General Motors chassis. It's the Ford. All the cars have Ford hubs.
Yeah.
Ford brake systems, Ford rear ends,
and differentials. Yeah.
You know, I mean, it's you know, it's a it's now it's about the talent of the driver. I mean,
well, you know, no, it's about how
back
much
then it was about who built which company was building the most powerful engine, because there was no aerodynamics involved. It was which companies were building the most powerful
engine. I want to see stock cars.
That's what I'm saying. Back then.
I
the
know
that cars had no aerodynamics involved.
Yes, we're talking
building
past
them
each
in the
other.
Wind tunnel for racing.
I want to see that again. You know, I want to see Ford versus Chevy versus Toyota versus Dodge.
But see, what I'm saying now is even the cars they build that they put on the street all go through wind tunnel aerodynamic bullshit. They all do now.
I'm just saying now. You want to impress me, Pops? That thing we saw on Twitter with the double decker
buses
racing.
That shit was
that was some shit, boy.
But see, that's my thing, Doc. I like racing. I don't care what it is. I'll put two sticks in the gutter in the fucking water running down the gutter and see which one wins.
Yeah, but the double decker buses.
Oh, that was great.
That was amazing.
What the fuck?
But there's no room. There's really no room for anybody in the back to pass. With the two in the front fighting for the lead, there's just no
well,
room
that's,
for anybody.
Let's
back
take to the. Let's take that and put those guys in Le Mans.
That's kind of how I feel about like Formula One. Sometimes it's like the tracks are so tight that there's really no passing except in the pits. You
well,
know?
they managed to do a good.
Only bit. Only the ones that are like way faster coming up on the lappers and shit. They go by them pretty fast, but
yeah,
you know, I mean, the top three, top four guys, they're right in the line, and they it's a hard time passing each other.
Yeah, there's I've seen Formula One cars in person. They don't even sound like cars; they sound like jets.
Yeah. And I'll tell you what, like Cleveland, when they raced down that old airport,
yeah,
in Cleveland, that was great because that shit was like 15 cars wide, man, and they come off the corner however they wanted and haul ass down the straightaway, right? There was actually room to race in Formula One. There's like one line coming off corner. And,
I want double decker bus racing to become America's national pastime.
School buses here.
The UK's going to have to start it because they have all the double deckers. So, Rich, get on that, will you?
They do school buses. They do the school buses.
Any money?
Yep. Yeah, they do. They do. But I don't want to see them modified. You can put a roll cage in. You can put in safety gear, but that's it. It's got to be bone stock.
If you ever seen the figure eight racing where they're either dragging a trailer or school buses and shit. Those are the best, dude.
I would go watch that.
That's not me. I'll watch anything. I'll watch boats race. I'll watch planes race. I don't care. I'll watch races.
I used to go to the midget races.
Midget races.
Midget racing.
You watch midgets race?
Aren't you a midget yourself?
The midget cars on the dirt track.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I got a guy that lives around the corner from me that does pro dirt track.
Mental midget.
And he'll roll out on the weekends with his trailer and his rig, and he comes back on Monday and it's all mangled up and he spends all week fixing it.
Yep. That's the life of a racer right there. Especially a local, like small time racer, man.
Oh yeah, he is. He is. But apparently they have quite the fan following because on Fridays he's up the hill from me. There's a line of cars in Winnebago's lined up ready to follow him every Friday. That's got to be fun.
Party time. Look, racing is a party. If you go to the track, it's a party. I don't care what track, where.
It is.
Racing is a party. The people there like to party. They went there to have a good time. You know, I ain't never seen a fight break out at a racetrack.
I don't ever do anything to have a good time.
Fans fight at a racetrack. I've seen drivers fight. I've never seen fans fight.
So yesterday I went to my local coffee shop, which I used to visit twice a day, every day. First time in a year and a half that I've set foot in there. And I knew nobody. There's a whole new staff. None of the locals hanging out. Did I know them?
Coffee didn't taste the same. Nothing.
Coffee was still amazing. Still amazing. But I was just sitting in there and nothing's changed. All the art is still the same on the walls. You know, the decor is all still the same. And I was like, God, I miss this place. And then I looked and they had changed the hours. They're closing at 6 now instead of at 10. And I'm like, what the hell? So I asked the young lady behind the counter, what's with the new hours? Well, we only have 2 employees now. So COVID really hurt them bad.
Everybody bad.
So go to safehousecoffeeroasters.com and buy yourself some legacy coffee. Best you'll ever have. And support them. They're a small business.
I will not.
Carol, there goes your Rice Krispies for the day.
Yeah, well, I wasn't getting them anyway.
You have a stinky, smelly soul.
I do. I'm a horrible person.
Your soul smells like Tyndale collard greens.
Good.
Oh, God.
Rich, is this Nikki from the Guardians of the Galaxy?
I have no idea who this is.
Hello?
Anybody?
Oh, it probably is. I don't know.
She had the fire hair. She was.
No, that's right. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I think so. Petite.
I was thinking, like,
I don't know. I'm just drawing. Yeah, that's who it is.
No, he's right. He's right. I kind of based it loosely off of that.
You did not.
But it turned. I did too. Ugly
you
face.
You did not. You didn't. I was even did. Know what you're talking about.
Buyer.
I did.
DC.
Let's ask the lore masters. The lore masters would be Q and Pops. Nikki from the original Guardians of the Galaxy. They had Charlie 27 and Martin X.
Yeah.
And Vance Astro, Starhawk.
Yep.
You guys remember Nikki? Yondu.
They had Yondu.
Yondu when he was actually an archer. Yeah.
Who's that? Who's the blue guy?
I'm a little bit closer.
Remember when the Guardians of the Galaxy was a loser title?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
I do.
I wasn't alive yet.
Yeah. I'm surprised.
There's a lot of things that happened before you were alive.
Yeah, there were.
Dang, you're breaking my narcissistic...
The timeline is called BY, also known as Before You.
It's BY, yeah. Anything before Vic is old.
That was savage as fuck, you.
BY before you.
This is why I avoid the lunch hour. Q's just going after me so much.
I love you, Q.
Of course. Love y'all.
Q has the most contagious laugh I've ever heard in my life. When he gets cracked up, I lose my shit laughing.
Hey, Q, manju and scate katsu.
What?
He's using that same that same untranslated insult. I don't know. It's like all the fucking time. That joke is older than you, if that's at all fucking possible.
It's zygote. Italian for eat a sloppy dick.
All right. Yeah. All right.
Yeah. Because I spoke Italian for a long time. Then I met Rich. I'm not doing this.
No. God.
Yeah.
Carol, who asked you?
Someone get the other toddler.
Yeah. I'm usually not mean to kids, but this kid, he just,
What? I
don't care if anybody asks.
There's reasons I didn't have kids, and you're one of them.
It's probably for the best.
Good one,
given,
Don.
You.
That tadpole's like the definition of pull out and pray.
No wonder that rhymes. There's not a word that rhymes with tadpole.
I hear you.
I think a lot of words there were with that.
Now I'm uncomfortable. I'm uncomfortable.
Well, that's why I draw this.
Do you see that little button on your screen that says leave? You can feel free to push that anytime if you're feeling uncomfortable.
She said leave. Bye.
Damn, I should be mean to him because he is a kid, but oh my god.
They're kids. They're little assholes.
I know.
We gotta toughen them up anyway. No, this is like a safe place.
Where?
Their mind is like a sponge. They can absorb anything they see or hear.
Yeah, well, he keeps absorbing the weird stuff and the not cool stuff and the not... Don't be a dick thing. I don't know. He's a kid. I could be a dick.
You tell him, Dawn.
You tell him, Dawn.
Yeah. What are we telling him?
Yeah. Go tell him. Yeah.
It's hard.
Yeah.
I did stuff for Michaela on the computer today. And it's really hard to do when I hear him talking because it makes me just cringe and lose my train of thought.
Tell him that you can't take this shit no more.
You hear that?
Why do we keep letting the child in?
Well, we let you in.
Somebody else.
Like 5 minutes left of the show. Can we just like get through it? Can we do that?
Yes, we can.
Yep.
I'm the worst mascot.
I want to thank.
Don't invite me to go in. That's damn. That will never happen.
I want to thank Amanda for coming out and putting up with all us crazy people. I'm sure she's probably not still watching because why?
No, she wants to actually start appearing. She wants to actually start showing up on the draw stream.
That'd be cool. I gotta go, guys.
Bye.
Good.
Bye.
Bye. Doc called her up and said, "Get back in the basement.
Get over here."
Is it from Mortal Kombat? Anything? Do I have a face for you guys?
Who cares?
Because my camera's on.
Harry, reach out to us if you really want to talk.
Yeah.
Reach out to us.
What?
Reach out to all of us, Carrie, if you want to talk.
Yes, Carrie, please reach out to me. That is my name. Please find me on Facebook and such.
Yeah.
All right.
Please do.
Doc, weren't you a licensed therapist?
Was being the key word. He can't practice.
I don't think he's there anyway.
I know he can't practice, but I feel like he could help, you know?
Get your shoulder.
Yeah.
What happened?
I'm not worried about Terry.
Of course we're concerned, and we love you, Gary. We need you around for long time.
Guys, I'm going to get going because I got a long day tomorrow. I got to get up at like 6. Thanks, everyone, for showing up.
I'll
see all you cats later.
I got to bounce as well. Good to see you, Rich. Thanks for having me.
Rich, bye.
I'm going to see you tomorrow. Well, Carissa's champion's closing tomorrow.
Right on. Right on. All right. Peace out, everybody.
We're doing the countdown on the Monday Madness tomorrow at 3 o'clock for Worthy Chaos Redemption 1-5. You'll want to be here for that, promise.
Jeez, and you guys are mean. See you guys.
Bye, Vic.
See you, Vic.
I see how it is, Bobs.
Bye, Q.
Bye, Bobs.
I'm going to play some videos. Y'all have a great weekend.
Have a good one.
Peace.
Madness Entertainment Group presents the Madness Comic Network with original programming and additional comic-related content.
Civil War was America's bloodiest conflict. Over 500,000 died to preserve national unity. When the war ended, Confederates like Harley Brogdon headed west, shooting game with the army and gambling. When a card game turns deadly, Harley shoots in self-defense, killing the card sharp who threw down first. Wilfred Knorr, the card sharp's wealthy father, will stop at nothing to see Harley hang. Harley flees to Cobb's Gap, an old silver mining town at the foot of the Rockies. A remarkably peaceful town, especially after dark. But the sheriff harbors a dark secret, and no one dares go into the mines anymore. Cobb's Gap is full of secrets. People speak in hushed tones of something in the mines. Something worse than their cursed sheriff. Something even the Indians fear from the deepest pits of hell. Every secret will be exposed. Bronze Star. Order your copy at BronzeStarComic.com.
Comic Books for Kids provides comic books to kids in hospitals and cancer centers across the U.S. It's a place where we can all work together to make sure every child has a comic book. 100% of all proceeds go towards the kids. It's about making a difference, and while they're in the hospital, allowing them to fly like a superhero, battle dragons, or rescue teddy bears. We are in every state in the country, and now support over 160 hospitals. Every month, we add more.
Visit cb4k.org.
How do you end this thing? How do you put the... Where was the brakes on this bus? I forgot.
Jazz hands. Jazz hands.
Have a good night.